I'm a big fan of My Hero Academia. I love it because everyone has superpowers, even the civilians. Because of this, superheroes are so commonplace they have schools set up to teach kids how to superhero. Kids could say, "When I grow up, I want to be a superhero." And it would be a realistic dream. And I love it because the powers are so unique. Let me list some of my favorites. Blood Curdle, Supliant, Earphone Jack, Vagine, Hardening, Lockdown, Meatball, Mimicry, Razor Sharp, Solidaire, Telescopic, Twin Impact. I could go on. The powers are so unique that it's easy to make your own for pretty much anybody. Cam Steady, Quirk Uproar. The louder he screams, the stronger he gets. As I watched through it for the first time, I started to forget about Class B after they leave the stage. They didn't really do much except use Monoma as comedic relief. Once the joint training arc kicked in, and I listened to the Class 1B Cypher by Aegistall, I realized just how busted these kids are. And if Class A didn't have plot armor, they would whoop ass. I'm Black, I'm Bag, and today we're drawing my favorite students from Class 1B, plus a little surprise at the end. Zenkai Bara. Hero name, Spiral. Quirk, Gyrate. He can make any part of his body rotate at high speed like a drill. Okay, I'm not gonna lie. A lot of Class B's hero names suck. Don't get me wrong, there are bad ones in Class A too, but there are a lot more stinkers in Class B. We have Awase. What's his quirk? Weld. What's his alias? Welder. Subaraba's hero name is Subaraba, and Kamakiri named himself Jack Mantis like he's not a turtle or something. He's a turtle, right? So I came up with better names. Let me know if you want to hear them, and maybe I'll make a follow-up video. Right now, we're talking about Kaibara. I changed his hero name from Spiral to Spinjury, a portmanteau of spin and injury. I love names where the last part of the first word matches up with the first part of the last word. I also just love the word portmanteau. I don't think you realize how cool Kaibara's quirk is. As seen in the joint training arc, Kaibara used his spinning to enhance his punches and kicks. If you've ever been clocked in the nose by a football, you'd know how much a hit from something that rotates can hurt. Being hit with something that rotates at high speeds can also cause friction burns. And along with his added spiral claws, he can cut your face like one of those IKEA apple slicers. He can also move around super fast by spinning his feet. It's no one for all, but I think Gyrate is a crazy cool quirk. And just like Kaibara's costume, it's simple and effective. Manga Fukidashi. Hero name, Comic Man. Quirk, Onomatopoeia. Manga can materialize words in midair by speaking them. These words are onomatopoeia, which can manifest the effects of the phenomenon that the sound suggests. Right off the bat, I get the comic theming, with his name literally meaning cartoon speech bubble. But why is his quirk called comic? I get that comics have those pop, bang, pow, and bam effects were extra wha-bam when they went off. It's making my heart go ba-dum, ba-dum. But onomatopoeia isn't exclusive to comics. It's its own category of figurative language. Why is his hero name Comic Man? That's just really dumb. So I propose revising manga's hero name, the Sticks and Stones. Sticks and stones will break your bones, and then his words will hurt you. Manga has my favorite quirk ever. Not only does he make sound effects and manifests the effects, he manifests the word alongside it. I also wonder about the limits of his quirk. I don't know much about Japanese onomatopoeia, but at one point he says damn. So is it any word or just onomatopoeia? Is there a Japanese onomatopoeia word for moist? Step in something moist that goes squish or squelch. Maybe manga's saying something like that. If he says something like fire, will fire appear? As for his costume, I'm not a big fan of the milk bottle boots, but the simplistic design helps highlight the main thing you should be focusing on, his head being a giant manga fukidashi. Manga has a cool design, an even cooler quirk, and disproportionate screen time. Some of these guys need a lot more love. Juzo Hananuki. Hero name, Mudman. Quirk, softening. Hananuki can soften any living thing he touches. Hananuki is just cool. His quirk, his alias, his costume, even his face. I see why Ectoplasm got him in through recommendations. His quirk specifies non-living and not inorganic matter. So I wonder if he could soften someone's hair. The cells in your hair are dead, which is why it doesn't hurt to get a haircut. Hananuki could soften grass in the Paranormal Liberation War. Does living only mean sentient things, like dogs or people? Or is this just an oversight on account of this being a made-up anime world? I hate the explanation of it's all made up or it's a TV show to justify things not making sense. Sometimes you do have to rely on that backing, like how Aizawa's binding cloth works. But for other things, it just takes the fun out of talking about the show, because everything can be written off and ignored by acknowledging it's fiction. Sorry, I got a little distracted. Speaking of hair...
Imagine hair like a paragraph ago.
Speaking of hair, how does Haranuki's hair not get goo stuck in it when he swims through the softened stuff? His helmet has a respirator for breathing, but nothing for his hair. Conversely, how does Haranuki talk without lips? Gotta be like how Ripjaws does it. Are all my favorite characters ones with teeth outside of their mouth? When I first saw Haranuki and learned about his quirk, I thought his teeth were like that because his skin was softened and his teeth kind of poked through a little. It was an interesting idea, but I don't know how that would work practically. I swapped out the white in Haranuki's costume for a forest green. If you watch my Ben 10 Alien Pokemon Fusion video, you'll know green and orange is my favorite color scheme. Joe says it looks better if I leave it white, but I'll let you be the judge of that. Haranuki's just cool. Enough said. Setsuna Tokage. Hero name, Lizardy. Quirk, Lizard Tail Splitter. Setsuna can split her body into up to 50 pieces, levitate, and control them remotely. I love how unique Setsuna's quirk is. She's good in surveillance, but imagine getting jumped by 50 pieces of the same person. In the show, her fight was mainly used to show off Bakugo and how he's not only stronger, but a kind and caring teammate whose heart has grown 3 sizes after his time in the remedial course. Because of this, Setsuna, Awase, Kamakiri, and Bando barely got any time to shine. I also looked at her character profile in the manga, and she likes dinosaurs. Oh hey, I like dinosaurs. Maybe wondering by now why I'm not drawing Setsuna's hero costume, but that's because I'm redesigning her from the ground up. I get the lizard design she was going for, but sharp teeth and green hair aren't gonna cut it. Seeing as the series is about to end, and I doubt any more canon attention will be put on Setsuna, I took it upon myself to think up a favorite dinosaur for her. A Margosaurus. If any of you are wondering, my favorite is a Theogonator.
No one was wondering!
I gave her a few more Saurian traits, like a Margosaurus shoulder spines for decoration, claws on her boots and gloves, and Bahadosaurus spines on her armlets for offense. They can fold back when not in use to rotate 360 degrees for... I don't know, fullness. She also has a ponytail because it looks cool. I changed her hero name because obviously. Amargosaurus was named because it was found on the banks of the La Amarga stream in Argentina, so its name should just mean Amarga's lizard. But when translated straight from Portuguese, Amarga means bitter. So I changed Setsuna's hero name to Bittersweet. The grid pattern could use some work, and the colors might be a bit much, but I like it. Pretty cool redesign fitting of a way cooler character. You might think we're done, but that's because you didn't pay attention to anything I said initially, did you? Before we get to our bonus, yeah, I know, skip here if you've heard it already. You know what? I'll make this quick. If you like My Hero, join my Discord server. We got lots of people to talk about that with, along with many other things. Discord members also saw this video before you guys on YouTube did. It's like Patreon, but for free, because I have no idea how to set up a Patreon. And if I did, nobody would subscribe to it. Also hit the buttons below so I can grow and maybe get money off this YouTube stuff. 50% away from being 80% away. Is that fast enough?
We have a little bit of time left, but I mean, not too much.
Okay. I'll use this to tell you guys about one of my stories. Okay. So there's this mon- Ilobara Fukidashi. Hero name, Loony Bin. Quirk, Toon Force. Ilo has a secondary cartoonish form granting him enhanced speed and strength, hammer space, fourth wall manipulation, and weaponized Looney Tunes shenanigans. While in Toon form, Ilo's body becomes rubber-like, giving him nigh indestructibility, squash and stretch, and high pain tolerance. His Toon form absorbs the impact of most blows to protect his body, but he can still feel pain if hit hard enough. If you haven't deciphered by now, Ilo is me, in MHA. He's still a work in progress. I'm not sure if there's more for Toon Force to do, but I love what I have for him right now, and he's probably my most fleshed out OC. If you look closely enough, there are subtle references to cartoons and other animated things I like in his hero costume. Here, I'll give you a list of all of them. If you haven't guessed by the last name, Ilo and Manga are twin brothers. Manga has my favorite quirk, and it's the closest thing to Toon Force outside of everyone's plot armor. Manga and I are also just the same person. Manga likes drawing and making children laugh. All he needs is dinosaurs and nerdcore music to top it all off. Let's end today's video with some random facts about Ilo. Ilo's favorite hero is Gang Orca. So on a trip to the Okuto Island Aquarium, he posed for a picture with Gang Orca and got so scared he punched him through a wall. Ilo is friends with Mina and Kirishima. They spend their free time daring each other to do stupid things. Ilo once used Manga's head to clean up spilled Gatorade at 2 a.m. and hasn't told him since. Ilo's dad is Japanese and his mom is Nigerian. When they found out they were having twins, they agreed that dad would name the older one and mom would name the younger one. That's why Manga's name is in Japanese and Ilo's name is in Yoruba. Ilo's name is a portmanteau of the Yoruba words for endless and power. Ilo has a little sister named Noiji. I'm gonna keep this short. Comment your favorite drawing down below. Let me know what I should do next. Join the server, click the buttons, yada yada yada. I should start putting light goals on the videos. Not going to be too ambitious, so if this video hits 50 likes, I'll make a part 2 where I draw my favorite characters from class 1A. That's probably too much anyway. My Black Brawlhalla drawing got like 12 likes. Go watch the other videos I posted today. Maybe you'll like those. I'm still Black, and I'll be back. Peace.